I welcome you all in this 9th Krishi Gyaan lecture series on Family Farmer, Future of Agriculture Marketing. It is considered to be an honor and privilege to invite and welcome Dr. G.S. Kaushal, former Director of Agriculture, Government of Madhya Pradesh. I request Honorable Director General Sir to introduce the speaker.
Good morning, all of you. So, a hearty welcome to 9th Krishi Gyandeep Knowledge Series lecture. And I would like to extend a warm welcome to esteemed speaker of today's program, Dr. G.S. Kaushal, former Director of Agriculture, Government of Madhya Pradesh. It is our privilege to, you know, invite Dr. G.S. Kaushal, now who is all along his 4 decades of service to farmers and agriculture, he promoted this concept. See, normally I was just sharing with my colleague, friend Dr. Vikram Singh. See, if people who are outside the system, who are out of the department, some social activist and some people, you know, who civil societies, whatever they work, it becomes a big news actually. But if a government employee with all the dedication, 3 decades, 4 decades, even though they work in the, within the system, sometimes they don't see the light of the day. And we are seeing one such person in front of the light, Dr. G.S. Kaushal. So 4 decades he promoted, you know, organic agriculture in Madhya Pradesh, which became a role model for the entire country. And today, if they are achieving double digit growth rate in agriculture, probably the very strong foundation laid by Dr. G.S. Kaushal is very much a contributing factor. Friends, he is going to talk about family farmer. So this family farmer is a very interesting concept. We heard about family doctor. If you are sick, you will go to a doctor. But you know, you in the process, you discover one doctor who can listen to you and respond to you very positively, very affectionately. He treat not only you, your entire family. He will become very close to family. He will become a family doctor. And this family doctor and the family association is a lifelong. We just trust him. Whatever he says, we just follow it without questioning. Now Dr. G.S. Kaushal, he is promoting a concept called family farmer. The farmer who is trusted by another family unquestionably, and they depend on him for supply of food, quality food throughout the life, so that a family farmer market is ready-made. So today, a farmer who produces more than 75% of the marketable surplus is looking here and there, searching for a viable market. Suppose 10 families support one farmer, I think his marketing problem is solved. It is my privilege to introduce Dr. G.S. Kaushal background. Dr. G.S. Kaushal, probably maybe one or two people were born when he joined the job here. Rest of the people, we were not there actually. So before 1964, he completed, you know, his doctorate in soil science from Jabalpur University. That time, I think Kaushal Saab Agriculture University was not there. Yes, it was Jabalpur University. He completed soil science. And in 1964, he joined the university. And even though, you know, joining university was a very prestigious assignment or profession for the young people during that time, that too with a doctorate, he had a passion for field work. So he went to field and, you know, became, because his discipline is soil science, he became a soil survey officer. There was a field unit and he was taking care of soil survey. Just imagine, during 1964, people were talking about soil health management during that time. Now later, you know, for a decade he worked for soil survey unit. Then he shifted to department, and department he occupied various positions. and finally till retirement, you know, for nearly 9 years, it is one of the longest period, Dr. G.S. Kaushal was Director of Agriculture in Madhya Pradesh. We value your experience, and we would like to hear from you how you sailed in agriculture development, and especially while promoting family farmer concept, because that is an answer to agriculture marketing today for 4 decades. That is the theme we are going to hear from Dr. Kaushal. So it's our privilege, sir, and I would like to extend a warm welcome to you on behalf of NIAM, all my colleagues and our student friends here for this talk. Thank you very much.
Friends, Dr. Chandrasekhar, other dignitaries in the hall. First of all, I would like to thank my old friend, Dr. Chandrasekhar, who knows me since last 20 years. And we have worked together. The public-private partnership model, that was unique. And at that time, Dr. Chandrasekhar, myself, Dhanuka group, and even 5-7 ministers of the state, including chief minister, were there on the dais. They inaugurated, and we successfully implemented the model. That was the success, and that constant effort, what we were made there, resulted in the productivity award for continuous 9 years to the Madhya Pradesh, and the focus point was Hoshangabad district. So that is the background. Now initially, actually I am a soil scientist, work up to 90 with the soil survey of the department. And there used to be one organization dealing with the state, all the irrigation project, Narmada Sagar, everything, we have to deal with that. And then shifted to the extension side in 1990. My interest was in extension. And thereafter, I worked, realized the problem of the soil, realized the problem of soil in Punjab, and we initiated, say in early days 1998, the concept of scientific organic farming system, cow-based organic system in the state. Though it was the first, but I don't claim that it was in the first in the country, but it was recognized, and the many states, even your Uttarachal Secretary, Chief Secretary, APC, they used to visit my model farm, which we developed near Bhopal, 20 kilometers from Bhopal, as a model. You must demonstrate what you want to say. And at that model farm, in 1998, and then 45 farms of the state government, we start implementing. 50% area we kept in organic farming, 50% in chemical farming. We waited, and after 4 years, when we got the success, comparable result, not that chemical is good or organic is good, the comparable results were there. Then we went before the farmers. In 2002, we started with one village in each, you say, development block. There were 313 development blocks in the state of Madhya Pradesh. And in the first year, we developed 313 villages in the state. Then in the second year, we again added 2 villages. And in third year, in 2004, when I retired, there were 5 villages and 1565 villages in the state were ready to take up organic farming, and they disseminated. Meanwhile, it has somewhat slowed down. But however, even after my retirement, I continue to work on the system of organic farming, start popularizing working with the farmers independently. And you see, it took me from 1998 to 2018, 20 years to develop the concept with respect to the organic farming, different concept, etc. And when I discussed with Dr. Chandrasekhar about the farmers, family doctor and family farmer, he has forgotten the family doctor, but he has catch up the family farmer and the future of that agriculture marketing, because this is the Institute of Development of Agriculture Marketing. And I also got that point, definitely, after all, we want to develop the farmer. So initially started working. Now initially we were interested in the development of the farmer and development of the system. The organic farming system must be adopted by the farmer. Otherwise everybody was doing the chemical farming and so many problems was there. So working with the farmer, not taking any care for the produce, marketing, what will happen to the marketing, it does not come in our mind. But then when the cultivator adopted, they used to consume themselves and then used to come before me, what to do? We have produced the organic. And at that time, even the scientists, they don't want to hear about the organic farming. When they used to come, when I organized one international center conference at Bhopal, agriculture minister, DG, etc., everybody was there, and I heard DG saying, Dr. Kaushal, pata nahi kya karte rehte. He is doing organic. The bhuka mar jayega. There were misconceptions. The going population will go hunger. And I used to say them that I have tested, there will be no decrease in the production. There will be decrease in the production cost and there will be value addition. But nobody was ready to hear. And now you are hearing that everybody, even at the top level, is talking about the organic farming, maybe in different form, but everybody wants to go toward the organic farming. So that was the stage. Of now, there were misconception. Everybody used to say they produce organic only for export. It must be certified. Heavy certification charges were there. At that time, all Switzerland companies were there and wanted to make it for a higher category people. I was not agreeable even from the very beginning to this subject. I asked that a person, a farmer, who has produced the healthy food, better for our health, who has the first right to eat it? You will also say, the first right is of the producer, farmer and farmer family. So I used to say that it is the right of the farmer and farmer family. Then of that people, of that farmers of that village, other villages, and if there anything remains surplus, then you can talk about the export. After all, why the outsider? They require chemical free food. It is good for the health. You are not required to spend on the money. That's why they require it. They will give you the lot of dollar. But I used to say my farmer that you will not yield dollar. If you export, you have to consume medicines. From the export, you will get some money and that money will go to the medicines. So start consuming yourself. And after this 20 years, I come to the conclusion that we must develop the self-sufficiency to the farmer. Farmer marketing system should be developed of their own. Now, I used to ask, when deliver the lecture, and then one lecture, some Israeli people were also sitting there. Because they have taught us, and they have also taught us about the chemical farming. So I used to ask them, whether would you like to eat poison? But why should we eat the poison? Because you are eating poison every day. 0.5 milligram of pesticide residue is going in our body every day. Every day, if you calculate, it is 170 to 180 milligram in a year. If I consume 170, 180 milligram of pesticide residue of poison at a time, what will happen? I will die immediately. But I am taking daily. The slow poisoning of my body is going on, and which is resulting in all these diseases which we were never used to heard, that is your cancer, diabetes, heart, they are also very common even in the villages. Now, coming to the next, as we have talked about the family doctor, I will come in detail later on, but you see, my body is very sensitive. And we are also very sensitive. We can't tolerate little disorder in the body, a problem, and even we get a fever, a temperature, 100 degrees centigrade, we will rush to the doctor. And everybody maintain a family doctor. Family doctor, whether I have any problem, but I will first go to my family doctor. He will treat me, give me first aid. It may be relief one to me, or he will refer me to a specialist of that particular disease or problem. Now, think over. You are not getting ill every day. You are not getting ill. Sometimes you feel ill. But you are maintaining a cordial relation with the doctor. The doctor must be there. But have you thought? Our body requires healthy food. We must have all the nutrients, everything. But have you inquired, or you tried to know from where this food or raw material is coming? From where these vegetables are growing? Under what condition? What chemicals are used? I have seen. And everybody know that in big metro cities, big cities, vegetables are grow around the city area. And around the city area, most of the vegetables are irrigated with sewage water. Sewage water containing heavy metals and microbes, injurious to my health. But you are eating. You are not asking. Even the Green Tribunal, Pollution Control Board of the state and authorities, they all know. Sometimes they impose the order that the vegetables will not be grown under sewage water. But it is going on and we are eating it. Secondly, if you consider, I have surveyed the area around Bhopal, and in Bhopal there is a big talab, tank area from where the drinking water supply used to take place. I have surveyed 300 cultivators, examined them, and I found that none of them were cultivating without fertilizer and pesticide. They are using banned chemicals, which are banned for the vegetables, using freely. And when I tested the pesticide residue in the samples, I found those banned chemicals, on which were permissible. The limit was 40 times higher than permissible limit. What will happen? I have written an article that the Bhopal people are eating poison, drinking poison. But nobody is careful. Even there, no people are not careful. Now, coming to the tragedies of the pesticide, everybody have heard about the gas tragedy 1994 of the Bhopal gas tragedy. It is almost 35 years. I was there in service at Bhopal. I surveyed the area. There was no life below that the gas passes through. There was no life. And we used to locate neem plant. Wherever we find the neem leaf green, yahan gas ka asar nahi hua. That was the thing. So that was the worst in 1984. Then in recent year, there was a tragedy of endosulfan in Kerala. Kerala beetle was there. Attack of beetles was there on the kazoo. An aerial spray of endosulfan was undertaken. Aerial spray. Now there are a lot of open water bodies in Kerala. The aerial spray, the people who are moving on the street, endosulfan fell on their body. It was on your drinking water, everything. After 2-3 years, when the cases started coming from the hospital, the young men were deformed, bones were disordered, cancer cases were there, diabetes was there. Everybody was shocked. Then the chief minister of Kerala, can you imagine? Chief Minister of Kerala was on hunger strike. On hunger strike for banning the endosulfan. The endosulfan should be banned. That was the first step. Now, coming to the Green Revolution. All the benefit of Green Revolution and hand to mouth, etc., solved by the Punjab, Haryana and Western UP. They use lot of fertilizer, they use lot of chemical. And the after effect start coming after 5-10 years. You must have heard about a cancer train. Cancer train flying from Bhatinda to the Jodhpur, the historic city of Rajasthan. And every day 300 new patients travel in this train, get the treatment. And older patients also come for taking the medicine. So that train remain full of cancer patients, and that's why government does not name this as cancer train. The people who named the train as a cancer train. Now this is the lesson for the coming generation. And even the ladies of the Punjab, they have realized. And they have started the kitchen gardening in their on their farm and growing vegetables and other eatables for their own families without chemical. And this concept is now increasing all over the Punjab and also in other part of the. So now this is the case. Now if this is the case, so we must take care of our food, what we are eating, क्योंकि जैसा भी अपन ने कहा हुआ है, जैसा भी होगा अन्न, वैसा होगा तन और मन. It all depends. If your body is healthy, your thinking will also be healthy. Otherwise, you will not able to concentrate on your goal. So we have to concentrate on our this. So originally, I wanted to emphasize on family doctor, family, but then we find that this approach can help in marketing and making the farmer self-sufficient. And during this period, you see, I have developed 5-6 concepts. Whenever the time will come, I will explain them in detail. Today I will tell you only brief. The first is your family doctor, family, allies, family, farmer, paririk doctor, banam, parivari, kisan. Then, second is the farmer kitchen garden, kisan ki bagya. Can you think, a farmer having the land, but purchasing most of the eatable from the market. So he will produce wheat, he may produce paddy or grain, producing one or two vegetables, and some vegetables are by chance during the rainy season. जो भी होती है आपकी बेल वाली फसलें हैं उसने लगा दी और उसके घर के ऊपर छा गई तो लौकी गिलकी कद्दू हो गया. Otherwise, all other vegetables he purchased from the market. And those vegetables grown under chemicals, maybe two, three days old, and so on. And when I contacted the farmer, I tell them, why are you purchasing your eatable from the market? When you are having a sufficient land with you, I give them my own example. I am leaving the city and maintaining my rooftop kitchen garden. Every day I am going to my rooftop garden on the second floor, third floor of my house and growing all the seasonal vegetable. Every time my kitchen used to have 15 vegetables in a season, you can grow successfully in your house. So I used to give them example, भाई जब मैं अपने आप पैदा कर सकता हूँ तो आपके पास तो जमीन है, you are having the land and sufficient land, so you must maintain your bagia. Keep 2-3 acres of the land as per your family size. Grow all things, vegetable, fruits, everything you can grow, and one or two plant of your nimbu will be sufficient for your whole year. You can have seasonal mango, papaya, guava, sitafal. जो भी हो सकता है उस क्लाइमेटिक कंडीशन में ग्रो देम एंड एवरी टाइम योर किचन विल बी फुल ऑफ फ्रूट्स. अदरवाइज जनरली फार्मर डजंट परचेज फ्रूट्स फ्रॉम द मार्केट. बनाना विल बी देयर टू सीजनल व्हाट्स एवर सुटेबल टू द एग्रो क्लाइमेटिक कंडीशन कैन बी ग्रोन इन द किसान की बगिया. देन यू कैन कीप लिटिल एरिया फॉर व्हीट, से पेडी, पल्सेस, ऑयल सीड, एटसेट्रा, व्हाट एवर इज पॉसिबल. एंड इवन द स्पाइसेस, ऑल द स्पाइसेस विल नॉट बी ग्रोन ऑन दिस फील्ड, सम ही हैज टू परचेज फ्रॉम आउटसाइड, बट मोस्ट ऑफ द स्पाइसेस कैन ऑल्सो बी ग्रोन अंडर लोकल कंडीशन. may not be commercial viable, but will be sufficient for his family. And now you can't consume all the material you are growing. Because if you have one vine of, say, your lauki, gilki or kaddu is there in your house, you will not able to consume. Your family will not able to consume. You have to distribute it. Even at my residence, I am distributing the vegetables. We are in excess. So that is the case. So kisan must maintain his own. And then I ask the farmer, when you are maintaining your bagya, 2 acre land, you kept under organically grown, chemical free material, you will be healthy. Now under rest of the land, you can grow anything, whatever you like. But you will not require to sell that product immediately after the harvest. There is always used to be a glut in the market at the harvesting season. Where cultivators used to remain in hurry to sell and get some money. But when you are producing up for yourself, now you are required to purchase. What you are required to purchase from the market? Soap, which you can't manufacture. If you like, you can manufacture at your home also. But acetidiacin. Salt, namak, you can't produce. Cloth, you have to purchase from outside. And some other expenditure. So these tidbit expenditure you will get from that 2 acre of land selling the excess produce. And the rest will remain in reserve. Whenever you like, jab bhi aapko lage ki you are getting a price of in the market as per your requirement. So kyaan chahta hai na ki sab meri produce hai, mujhe apni kimat milna chahiye. I must get my price. But at this moment, he is not able to fix his price. So he has to sell things in at MSP. Now what is MSP? Government is declaring MSP by 24 crops. And there are nearly 124 or odd crops in our country is grown. But whether we are taking care of 24 crops? No. The government operation is only for wheat, paddy and some pulses. Otherwise the farmer has to sell those crops on the price prevalent in the market. So what is the use of MSP? Look, farmer, if having such arrangement and not requiring money at the time harvest, then he can fix his price. Yeah, I will sell my wheat at 3,000 rupees per quintal, not at 2,000 rupees per quintal. Then he will be happy and he will get the money as he requires. I have seen the cases in Madhya Pradesh. Madhya Pradesh is famous for growing sarbati chapati wheat. It is never sold at MSP 2,000 rupees per quintal. The farmer will not give it. It is always above 3,000. And if even it goes up to 5,000 rupees per quintal. And then when it is organic, again you get the prime price. So we must adopt such system. So farmer the bagya is very important, and then comes the producer consumer market. What is happening now at today? Producer is producing, he is marketing, and there is a middleman. All the profit, all the benefit of the producer and even consumer goes to the middleman. I have seen and studied that farmer get only 18% of the produce. And the rest is with the middleman and so. You might have seen that a tomato farmer is selling to a thok vikreta at the rate of 10 rupees per kg. But in the market, we are getting tomato at the rate of 30 rupees, 40 rupees per kg. Now, if the farmer can have the direct linkage with the producer and consumer, then definitely consumer will be benefited. He will get an appropriate price, and even the farmer will also get the appropriate price. And on this subject, on this philosophy, we are working and getting the success. I will tell you later on. And another important topic is that is the farmer village based lagu udyog, village based processing. So as we are talking about the Gandhiji 150th birth anniversary, I participated in so many seminars, delivered the lecture, but anybody remember the philosophy of Gandhiji? Gandhiji want to make village self-sufficient, farmer self-sufficient, no intervention from the outsider. Even he used to propagate, use your own cloth, khadi cloth, don't use imported cloth, etc. But now here, village-based, kisan-based processing unit is the most important thing in the today context and context of our health point. It's very important. Everybody wants. What you want? You want chakki brain atta. In the name of chakki brain, atta is available in the market. But you have seen, it is prepared in the big mills. Where is chakki? Chakki to wo apni purani jo chalti thi, gaon mein log chalate the, ab to wo they have become out of fashion. But even people want. So now marketeers are selling in the name of chakki brand. They want ghani ka tel, kachi ghani ka tel. People who are growing sarso, mustard, they know what is the ghani ka tel. Ghani ke tel ke aap nikla hua bottle kholo, to aapke aansu mein aansu aa jana chahiye. Are you getting tears in your eyes when you are opening the bottle of this oil, sarso oil? I have seen. Purchase the sarso oil especially. Open the bottle. There was no smell. Nothing was there like sarso. Now you want without polished rice, without polished dal. And all the big companies, even the Tata, etc., now they have catch up that idea. The people want the unpolished dal, unpolished rice. They are marketing it, marketing with higher price. When the processing cost is down, has gone down, because there is no expenditure on the polishing, everything. Double refined oil. Double refined oil. Why we need refined oil? Sarso, tilli, groundnut, whatsoever the oil seed we are having in our country, which we were consuming, they don't require even refinedness. They require simple filtration. And even if you get prepared oil from your local ghani and keep for a month or 15 days, whatsoever unwanted material is there, it will settle down and you will get clear crystal oil. when I was in the field, I used to purchase sunflower from the cultivator. Curdy ka tail bahut mana jata hai ki it is very good for the heart. But whatever the oil you are getting in the market, it is not pure sunflower oil. It is mixed up with so many things. Brown oil is there, soybean oil is there, you read the content. It is not pure custard oil. But I used to get it extracted in the local Ghani and keep it for a month or so. All the officers living in my colony used to get it pure custard oil and even less than the price of your refined, double refined oil. So that is the importance of your village-based industries. Now everybody of you want atta, rava, maida, papad. We have forgotten the taste of our homemade papad. Bali, which used to be get prepared from moong dal, oat dal. Now you are eating bari from soya. Soya bari, always the soya bari is available. But if this processing goes on in the village itself, we will get to the our old taste, old tinge of taste, which will be healthy, which was healthy for us. So this will, and this will, Gandhi ji ki jo parikalpana thi, ki all the village money should not go out of the village. The village people will get work in the village. They will work on for these all, even sitting in their home. They will not require to go outside. So employment will be created in the village itself, in the house of, in the family house of the farmer, and the migration from the village to the city will not take place. What we are having the policy? We want that our 70% population living in the city should come down to 40%. It has already come down to near about 60%, but planners want that only 40% people should cultivate, remain in the field, and rest could go to work. Now, imagine a landlord, owner of the land, malik of his own jameen, he kept 3-4 labor, etc., on his field, going to serve. Means he became from malik to labor. Landlord to the labor, we are making the labor and giving all his land to the industry. Industry will provide him the, something labor, they will not get the higher post. Mazduri banega, to malik ko mazdoor bana ke hum kya karenge? And then he is living in a good condition, open atmosphere, good space. If he comes to the city, he has to live in the jhukki jhopli, dirty condition, unhygienic condition, everything will be there. We are not able to manage even today population in the city. We are even not able to manage our cities. We are making small cities and destroying the villages. So make a smart village, provide all the facility in the villages, employment in the villages in the form of this industry, and there will be no need spending the huge amount in developing the city. So that is the another aspect. There are so many things which I go on talking. But now another aspect is rooftop kitchen gardening. I just struck the point, but I emphasize to the rural people who are living in the city to have the rooftop kitchen gardening. Every day you get the fresh material, fresh vegetable, and your atmosphere, environment will be friendly with you. So these all five, six concepts which I have discussed with you are interrelated. They are not independent of one or the other. Whenever the opportunity will come, I will discuss each and everything in very detail. Now, for me and for today, पारिवारिक किसान कृषि विपणन का भविष्य फार्मर फैमिली फार्मर फ्यूचर ऑफ दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड नाउ इज कमिंग टू दिस एज आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड फॉर एवरीबॉडी यूज्ड टू बी वेरी कॉन्शियस अबाउट द हेल्थ मेंटेनिंग द फैमिली डॉक्टर नाउ looking to all the and I say anyone you will be thinking they are I oppose so many problems health problem problem of sewage water sewage problem of excessive use of pesticide everything and you will be thinking that there is a poison everywhere and adulterated material lot of news are coming with the adulterated material, this is adulterated, this is adulterated, so many things are there. You must be thinking, and even the young generation, they will be definitely thinking, ki, what, where to live, what to eat, what to drink, and what not to eat, and what not to drink. The simple solution, I have the simple solution, that adopt a family farmer who will take care of your all daily needs, all your healthy material. Now there can be one person or group of person to cater the need of a consumer family. Because one farmer may not be able to produce everything. So there can be a group and you can have a good group providing all your things which are friendly to your health and friendly to environmental condition. So now come to the, that is the family farmer. Now what you are? At first instance, I say, that you can be your own family doctor, a family farmer. Because if you are having a land in the villages, you might be serving in the city, but you can manage to grow all of your need on your family land, farm land for yourself, at least for yourself. And if you are living in the city, you can manage to have a rooftop kitchen garden and managing for your vegetables at least. I will not say that you will grow the wheat and paddy etc. on the, your roof. Many people are growing even paddy on the roof in Chhattisgarh. But it is not possible on a large scale, but vegetable definitely we can go and meet out. So you can be, at first stage, you can be your own family farmer. Now, if you are not doing it, then you can adopt a farmer or a group of farmer from the nearby village of the, city or your residence. He may be a certified organic farmer, doing organic farming since last 3 years or more, and got the certificate. Or he may be follower of organic farming system, and not obtained the certificate, but doing farming without chemical, without fertilizer, or he may be agreeable to follow chemical free cow based farming system. You might have mind that in everything I am adding system, because organic farming is a system. It is not a single approach thing. So you have to adopt the system and follow that system, because it is not like that, that when insect appear, you spray the chemical and kill the insect. You have to start your precaution from the day of sowing. Every 10 days, you have to spray some non-chemical, you have to provide something, nutrient, every 10 days in form of say biogas slurry, liquid manure, organic manure. You have to do the seed treatment with ejectovector, rhizobi, everything. But you have to follow. You can't say that now today this insect has appeared and I will start doing the organic farming. Nothing will happen. And you will lose the crop. So you have to follow the system. And now that farmer which we are going to adopt, you must, he must be maintaining a kitchen garden. जो मैंने रूप की जो बगिया की बात की, किसान की बगिया, he must be maintaining. If he is maintaining, then he will able to provide you all the eatable and required material. And now you see, he must be having the character of friendly. He must maintain cordial atmosphere with you. Otherwise, if he is a root farmer, then he may bring anything and he will say that it is organically grown. So he must be cordial, friendly, and having that. And feel that cultivator are in the village, they have the village based cultivator based processing unit. If they are not having processing facilities or unit, they must be able, are agreeable to organize processing locally. If he get processed in that mechanized system, then he can serve the good purpose of a family farmer. Now what is their now duties of the family farmer? He must have some duties. The farmer charging reasonable price from the consumer. He should not ask acceptable higher price, too much price of his produce. So he must charge the agreeable price or reasonable price at par with the market. Next, then maintaining the cleanliness. It is very important in organic farming that he keep his field clean, processing clean, not washing vegetables in the sewage water. If he is washing in the fresh water, bringing fresh vegetable, not the old vegetable in the market. I have seen that chemical farmer, they just pick the vegetables and before bringing to the market, deep in 0.01% malathion. They deep in malathion and bring to the market so that shining remain there and it look like the fresh vegetable. हम वही चीज पसंद करते हैं ना जो बढ़िया दिखे, चमके दिखे. ये नहीं लगता कि वेदर इट इज कंटेनिंग द केमिकल्स. द मेलेथियन एटसेट्रा. तो ही मस्ट बी मेंटेनिंग द क्लीनलीनेस. देन ही मस्ट रेगुलर इन सप्लाईज. ऐसा नहीं चलेगा कि वंस इन अ वाइल ही सप्लाईज एंड रेस्ट ऑफ द टाइम आई एम depending on the market. He must be able to manage supply I say once in a week or twice in a week, that will be sufficient. So you can store them for a week and then later on it you follow the, and if required, the group of farmers can manage the home delivery of the product, taking the order. Even today the people, farmers are taking order on phone, WhatsApp, and making, providing at your doorstep, home delivery. That is a good facility. And another important point is faith. He must earn the faith of the family or the consumer. क्योंकि विश्वास नहीं रहा तो फिर कुछ भी नहीं टिकेगा. और मैं ये कहता हूँ कि जैविक खेती, ऑर्गेनिक फार्मिंग इज द खेती ऑफ फेथ, विश्वास की खेती है. सर्टिफिकेशन इज इम मटेरियल फॉर मी. यदि किसान बोलता है कि उस केमिकल के प्रोड्यूस किया है, ही हैज नॉट यूज द केमिकल पेस्टिसाइड, आई मस्ट बिलीव इन. मैंने स्टिल आई एम of the opinion that most of the farmer will not tell you a lie. जो भी होगा वो सही बोल देगा, क्योंकि अभी भी मेरे जो मार्केट की व्यवस्था चल रही है उसमें वो चीजें ही इज नॉट ब्रिंगिंग विच ही इज नॉट ग्रोइंग ऑन हिज फार्म. अदरवाइज वंस ही हैज गेन द फेथ ही कैन ब्रिंग एनी थिंग, इवन परचेजिंग फ्रॉम द मार्केट एंड सेलिंग टू यू, एंड यू विल बिलीव दैट he has brought the organic one. So they are not doing it. Whatsoever is grown on their farm, they are bringing to the market. So faith, for a faith is very well. Then, what is more important? Now in the present day, busy life, every urban population want to go on outing. That is rural tourism. It is also getting popularity. Now if you are maintaining a family farmer, you can go on rural tourism. Once in a week, you and your children go to the family farmer field. By going to his field, you can check the practices he is adopting. Your children who doesn't know what is a plant, how plant grow, whether potato is on the plant or below the ground, he will able to see. Matlab, he will be very near to the nature. He will know the nature. So you can visit his field, and even today, our farmer, even then he is having the capacity to honor you, host you, he will provide a good meal to you. Require, he will charge, but most of the farmer doesn't charge anything from his guest. So we'll enjoy your rural food, and urban population will be benefited. So this way, even he himself, our family farmer group or family, they can organize your trip. They can collect the group of consumer and ask them to come to their field for the enjoyment. So these lot of benefits are there. Now what is benefit? If the consumer and farmer interaction is there, demand is there, because there is a rule of demand and supplies. So if the consumer demand, farmer will start producing. So whatsoever I was saying, the farmer will start maintaining the bagya, farmer will start growing the organic. In this way, he will start growing the organic, his family will take the organic food, healthy food. And I was seeing the example that even that farmer family is fed up with the vegetables, because if they are growing all the vegetables suitable to that season, agroclimatic condition, they get lot of, or after supplying, they remain surplus. So, एक बच्चे ने अपनी माँ को बोला, बोले भाई तुम ये रोज रोज सब्जी बनाती हो, कभी कभी तो दाल बना लिया करो. मतलब they are not getting the opportunity to eat दाल. और previously before adopting this system, they were eating with दाल. And now they are getting vegetables. तो माय सेज टू इट मदर कि कभी कभी दो दाल बना लिया करो भाई. तो सी द इम्पॉर्टेंस. तो वो आपको जो है कंज्यूमर वेट स्टार्टेड, ही विल नॉट रिक्वायर टू डिपेंड ऑन द मार्केट. इसको डायरेक्ट मार्केटिंग फैसिलिटी इज अवेलेबल. ही विल सेल इज प्रोड्यूस टू द कंज्यूमर. ही विल नॉट बादर टू. एंड नाउ production farmer will get actual or reasonable price of his produce. So, hum jo bolte hain ki there should be doubling the income of the farmer. Now, in this way, there will be reduction in the production cost. Because in this system, I say to the cultivator that you have to have your input produce at your farm only. If you require organic manure, you produce yourself on the farm. Keep a cow as per your requirement. 2 cow, 3 cow, desi cow is required. So you must maintain the cow. So you can get all the nutrients. Biogas slurry will be there. The biogas slurry, he will get the light and gas. Will not have to depend on the city supply for the this HPG etc. LP. This government started the scheme supplying the gas cylinder to the rural population. And this scheme started first in Haryana. Chief Minister Haryana declared that we will distribute 1 lakh, 2 lakh cylinder to the rural population free of cost. I wrote a letter to them that it is not a good step. In rural areas, you are having lot of cattle. Introduce and popularize biogas plants there. They will use their waste in the biogas plant. Have the gas, they will use their gas themselves. If they are surplus, they can have the light, and even then surplus, they can supply to the other. And in place of that, there will be good manure available all the time. Because jab main Haryana wagera gaya aur jata hu, to main dekhta hu sadak ke dono taraf बड़े बड़े घोड़े, बड़े बड़े कचरे के ढेर लगे रहते हैं. बिकॉज दे आर नॉट मेकिंग प्रॉपर मेन्यूअर, प्रॉपर नॉट यूजिंग इट प्रॉपरली. नाउ दिस इफ ऑल दिस इज कोन ग्रोस टू द बायोगैस प्लांट, देन देर विल बी क्लीनलीनेस इन द विलेज. एंड इफ देर इज क्लीनलीनेस, देर विल बी नो मॉस्किटो एंड अदर इंसेक्ट पेस्ट. तो विलेज विल बी फ्री फ्रॉम डिसीजेज ऑल्सो. तो स्वच्छता का मिशन जो है वो भी अपने आप इससे सॉल्व हो जाएगा. तो ये है द क्लीन एटमॉस्फियर, फार्मिंग बिकम वाइबल फॉर द कल्टीवेटर बिकॉज नो एक्सपेंडिचर, गुड प्राइजिंग, बेटर प्राइजिंग. एंड अनदर इम्पॉर्टेंट फार्मर, एज आई टोल्ड यू अर्लियर, विल डेल डेली रिटर्न. क्योंकि आज भी जो बाजार में मेरे ला रहे हैं तो 5 दिन चलता है. 5 दिन उनको सब्जी आएगी तो नगद पैसा मिलता है, जेब में पैसा रख के जाता है. आपस में जो भी उनको डिस्ट्रीब्यूट करना है अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर कंट्रीब्यूशन, दे गेट इट एवरी डे, दे आर गेटिंग द मनी. तो दे विल नॉट फील शॉर्टेज ऑफ द मनी. and there will be no surplus in this system. Even today, whatsoever they are bringing in the market, it is sold there. And you will be surprised to know, even a vendor, yesterday there was market in front of my house. I offered them the place. My farmer was selling them, and the vendor who sell vegetable in the colony, he was purchasing vegetable from my farmer. I was really surprised by the price is higher. The vendor has to sell cheaper. Vendor is also old. Purchase mera. Maine usse pucha baad mein. Why are you purchasing from this farmer? Organic farmer is an organic farmer. Your vegetable may not be able to sell at that price. Well, no, I am getting my price. Menaka, how you are getting? Well, this farmer is bringing fresh vegetable without adding a single drop of water. It is without water. And he is giving, say in place of 1 kg, he is giving more. Uske paas kami ki nahi hoti hai, kyunki uska produce hai, to thoda bahut zyada bhi wo de deta hai. But when I will sell, I will add order, water, sufficient water will be there, aur main aapko 1 kilo ke bajaye 750 gram dunga. आप देख ही नहीं सकते हो कि तराजू में मैं क्या कर रहा हूं. तो यू विल गेट 750 ग्राम्स इन. सो आई एम इन प्रॉफिट एंड आई गेट ए फ्रेश मटेरियल. आज मेरा बच भी गया तो मेरा कल भी बिक जाएगा. तो इन दिस वे देयर विल बी नो रिमेन सरप्लस विद द प्रोड्यूसर फार्मर. नाउ गोइंग थ्रू ऑल, आई थिंक एवरीथिंग इज clear in your mind. Now there are some success stories. The first story is of my own that experience. As I told you, the genesis of this system took 20 years to me for coming to this conclusion. Even at present, I am working with 12 farmers, providing them all the technical know-how. Whenever they require providing training, all things is free of cost. They are meeting the need of 300 customers in 5 days in a week at different places in the city like Bhopal. They want to add another 500 by end of this year. There will be more than 12 farmers by that time. New farmers are also coming there. And I am encouraged with that. Even I am going to manage with them that the certification of their fields, so that in future, whenever there will be surplus, I will not feel any problem in supplying to the big metros like Bombay, etc., or even export. I have the meeting with one certifying agency in this afternoon for this purpose. The second example is at Indore. Since last 5 years, they are maintaining a Jaivik Setu. And in Jaivik Setu, cultivator, organic producers, they are bringing their material and selling on Sunday. Lot of people, city people, used to come and purchase there. And even they organize the feast. They get prepared organic food and serve to the consumer whosoever want to have it. Now third example, day before yesterday, I was in the Hoshangabad district where we work in the remote area, having the meeting with 100 farmers. They are organic grower or they want to grow the organic. संकल्प पत्र उन्होंने भरा कि नाउ वी विल बी हैविंग ऑर्गेनिक. व्हेन आई वाज डिस्कसिंग विद देम, सम ऑफ द पीपल हैव कम, फार्मर्स हैव कम टू मी, दे आस्क मी सर गिव मी द एज द लेआउट आप किसान की बगिया. सब हम अपने परिवार के लिए तो हम अभी से शुरू करना चाहते हैं, आप मुझे लेआउट दे दीजिए कि कहाँ क्या कैसा करना चाहिए. दे आर आल्सो ऑर्गेनाइजिंग ए ऑर्गेनिक मार्केट फर्स्ट संडे ऑफ एवरी मंथ इन इटारसी, ए बिग रेलवे जंक्शन ऑफ सेंट्रल रेलवे. लॉट ऑफ पीपुल आर कमिंग देयर परचेजिंग, बट देयर इज दिस आर कमिंग नाउ द परचेजर से यू आर प्रोवाइडिंग मी वंस इन ए मंथ, आई कॉन्ट परचेज वेजिटेबल फॉर ए मंथ, आर कैन इफ कैन आई परचेज इवन देन आई कॉन्ट कीप फॉर ए मंथ, सो आई वॉन्ट एटलीस्ट एवरी वीक. आई परसुएटेड देम एंड नाउ आई सी विद इन ए शॉर्ट टाइम बिकॉज दे आर कमिंग फ्रॉम ए डिफरेंट डिस्ट्रिक्ट प्लेसेज, नॉट इवन द डिफरेंट विलेजेस फ्रॉम द होशंगाबाद डिस्ट्रिक्ट, दे आर कमिंग फ्रॉम द नियर बाय डिस्ट्रिक्ट, हरदा इज देयर, नरसिंहपुर इज देयर, तो फ्रॉम डिफरेंट एरियाज दे आर कमिंग. और दे आर सेइंग दैट इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर अस टू कम एवरी संडे, वी हैव अदर वन. आज दे हैव वन आर टू पर्सन, एवरीबडी एवरी गोवर इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड टू कम टू द मार्केट एंड यू कैन ऑर्गेनाइज इट. और थर्डली आई हैव ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट केस ऑफ यूर पंजाब चंडीगढ़. वन डॉक्टर ही वेंट टू द मार्केट, परचेज लौकी, ही टेस्टेड लौकी, इट वॉज हैविंग ए बिटर टेस्ट, नॉट डेट बिटर टेस्ट विच इज पॉइजनस, बट इवन डेट लौकी वॉज हैविंग द बिटर टेस्ट. ही गॉट प्रिपेयर्ड द वेजिटेबल, इट वॉज ऑल्सो गिविंग द डेट टेस्ट, ही थॉट दैट इट माइट बी ए बेड क्वालिटी वन. देन इवन ही गोज टू द मार्केट, परचेज एन ऑर्डर लौकी, इट वॉज ऑल्सो सेम. तो ही इमीजिएटली डॉक्टर कम टू द कंक्लूजन दैट देयर इज समथिंग इन द ग्रोइंग प्रैक्टिसेस. वो डॉक्टर इंजीनियर 8-10 लोगों ने, चंडीगढ़ के लोगों ने, दे हायर द लैंड नियर बाय चंडीगढ़, कलेक्टेड 10,000 और 1 lakh रुपीज फ्रॉम ईच ऑफ देयर मेंबर, हायर द लैंड फ्रॉम द कल्टीवेटर, उन्होंने अपने लेबर रखे, सब कुछ रखा एंड स्टार्ट ग्रोइंग. विद इन 2-3 months दे आर नाउ गेटिंग सफिशेंट मटेरियल फॉर देयर कंजम्पशन, देयर सर्वेंट इज ब्रिंगिंग द वेजिटेबल, कीपिंग इट वन पॉइंट इन चंडीगढ़, वन पॉइंट इन मोहाली एंड अदर पॉइंट इन यूर द चंडीगढ़ कैपिटल, हरियाणा कैपिटल. तो 3 places दे आर कीपिंग द वेजिटेबल, कंज्यूमर्स आर कमिंग देयर, मतलब देयर पार्टनर्स आर कमिंग देयर एंड कलेक्टिंग. और वंस इन ए मंथ और वाइल, वेन एवर दे गेट टाइम, दे गो टू देयर फार्म, इंजॉय पिकनिक. मेनी मोर पीपुल आर कमिंग टू देम एंड वॉन्ट टू ज्वाइन देम इन दिस वेंचर. तो इन दिस वे वॉट इज फाइनली कंक्लूजन, कंक्लूजन इज दैट देर इज नो सरप्लस. इवन इफ सरप्लस इज देयर, तो नॉन पेरिसेबल मटेरियल द कल्टिवेटर विल स्टोर इन हिज ओन हाउस, ही विल नॉट ब्रिंग इट टू द मार्केट. आवर कल्टिवेटर नो हाउ टू कीप ग्रेन्स फॉर ए ईयर विदाउट एनी इंसेक्ट पेस्ट प्रॉब्लम, सो देयर विल बी नो स्टोरेज प्रॉब्लम, ट्रांसपोर्टेशन प्रॉब्लम, लॉजिस्टिक नो प्रॉब्लम it all will be saving and good market, good price the farmer will get. Thank you very much for the patience hearing. Now, if there are any queries, I will try to satisfy you.
Thank you, sir. Now, house is open for question answer session.
Talking from the farmer perspective, like if we are applying this program at a district level, then we will be benefiting to the farmers through this concept. But if we look at the larger pictures, then what about the shopkeepers and the marginal shopkeepers and other service providers who will be affecting because of this? Because maximum of the consumption like pulses and other things, we are consuming from that only. So from one side, we are benefiting to them, while other side of the economy, we are defending others' things, like small and marginal shopkeepers.
But have you thought about the malls? Different big malls are coming up in the cities, and people like us are going to the mall. And my retailer from whom we were purchasing is becoming jobless. Now in this system, even that retailer, because your farmer is not coming daily to the market, even your vendor can purchase the material from them. As I told you about one vendor who is purchasing material from them and selling to the consumer. So that will not be a big problem. And you see, for this purpose, this 12% will not be sufficient. If I have to cater the need of Bhopal city, I will require hundreds of such people who will get the employment. Some of the retailer can be work with them, get a reasonable price. Even one student of the college is working with the farmer. He comes with him, sell the material, and goes to his job in the city itself. So there will not be a big problem. But we have to create a large network. Or network, as I told you, there can be a single farmer, can be in the group. Then he can provide the material, home delivery. A person requires for the home delivery. So there will be requirement. There will be no non-employment. And even today, with those big malls, even small traders are surviving in our cities. हमारी जिससे वो होती है हम भी उसी के पास खरीदने जाते हैं तो दिस प्रोसेस विल कंटिन्यू ये हो सीन दैट वेंडर्स नाउ लॉट ऑफ मिल्क कमिंग इन पैकेट्स पैक पैकेट सांची का मिल्क आता है भोपाल में अमूल का आता है दुनिया भर का मिल्क इज अवेलेबल इन द मार्केट इवन देन इफ यू गो टू द सिटी लाइक इंदौर lot of villagers, they bring raw material on their motorcycle, cycle in a big container and the people purchase directly from them open milk. Because, as I told you, consumer must have the faith. So they have the faith on that milkman. They are purchasing from him. They will not be proud.
Thank you, sir.
Raise your hands, please.
Good afternoon, everyone. So I'm Divya Mishra. My question is that can PDS boost through this family farming? Because by making it mandatory to purchase it from the local farmers.
Pardon?
And apart from this, can it be a great idea to affect the inflation?
Mandatory, we can make mandatory anything. It is all optional. It is all will of the consumer. It is will of the farmer. He produces, he sells. So it cannot be mandatory.
Good afternoon, sir. My question is that the government scheme, which is Param Pragat Kishan Vikas Yojana, which promotes organic production, the turnout ratio of farmers in this scheme is very low. So what motivation should government give the farmers to encourage more production?
I don't want any motivation from the government. First thing, when the government system is there, there are a lot of formalities. I worked in the government system for 40 years and still I am asking my farmer, they are not taking anything, any subsidies or anything from the government, they are doing of their own. So that shows their intention. Intention must be there. Will hona chahiye, so you will manage everything. If required, you can take. But it is a simple, in this production system, there is nothing from the outside. He is not required to purchase anything as an input. I say them, you have your own seed. You have your own nutrient, you have your own pesticide, everything will be of yours. And the labor will be from the village itself. So nothing you required. Even on the government, I want only a first. You provide them the infrastructure. Say they require a cow shed, they require a biogas plant, transport facilities from the city to a village to city. That we can ask for, but for regular use, subsidy in everything is not required.
Thank you, sir. Good afternoon, sir. Sir, the family farmer concept is good, but it works in the case of vegetables, sir. But how this approach like works in the case of cereals, sir? Because for consumers are not directly connected to farmers in case of cereals.
What is the problem in that? No problem.
How a consumer can approach a farmer in case of cereals, like?
Well, you see, farmer is coming to the village, as I told you, that there are so many options open to select a family farmer. He may be that organic grower, he may be coming to the village, a consumer may not be knowing. But whatsoever the organization working in the city itself, a lot of farmers are coming to the city for selling that, he can adopt them. He can go to the village, ask to the village leader, who is the good farmer, how he is producing, what is his nature, and accordingly, he can select the farmer. You have to go to the village, you have to go to the community. After all, you will get the answer. Without going to the village or without approaching to the farmer, you will not able to know who is a real grower and who is having the qualities which I have mentioned you. So you have to go to the village.
Sir, I have one more question, sir.
Yeah.
Like, sir, these days organic farming and zero budget farming are growing good, but like, will these approaches cater the needs of growing population of India?
I have already mentioned you earlier, in early part of my lecture, that I have conducted trials for 4 years on my government farm, keeping 50% of the area under organic, 50% under chemical, and got the comparable produce. Now even today my farmer, some of organic farmer are growing, are getting return much more than your chemical farmer. Good, because you see, what is the theory of production? Plant require nutrient for growth, but we say that 12 nutrients, 16 nutrients are required, nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, everything. These are requirements of the plant. But what I say, it is all growth is controlled by microbes. Plant require microbes. Microbes are able to get atmospheric nitrogen, fixation of nitrogen takes place, phosphate availability takes place by the microbes. So many things. And as I told you, that you have to use regular, you have to feed regular. After all, we are eating 3 times a day. to provide nutrient at least for after 10 days to the crop, not daily. And these organic things, organic manure, you will go on adding, it will go on building the fertility of the soil. And it will remain in the soil. It is not like nitrogen. It will lose in the leaching, it will lose in the evaporation. There is no loss of organic. It will remain. First year, crop consume 40%, 60% remain in the soil, 30% next year, then again 60 year. So it remains for 33 years. And if you are adding continuously, the soil productivity will increase like anything. Water retention capacity increases because this organic is able to absorb much more water than workability. You will require less power. You don't require, will not require 90 horsepower tractor. My bullock power will be sufficient to handle the operations. So growing population will not go hunger. Even if they are eating two chapatis today, they will have sufficient nutrient, every seed, nutritious seed in one chapati. But I don't want to reduce their diet. They will get two chapatis. Per head production will not go at all. We are getting.